Hey guys, so I've been wanting to do this video on something I have been loving for the past 3 weeks. If you look at my makeup, you could probably tell that there's something missing. That's what I'm going to be talking about. So today, the item I'm going to be talking about is the L'Oreal Brow Stylist Definer. It is a very thin pencil. It's not like the Anastasia Beverly Hills one that is the triangle. It's similar to the NYX brow pencil and the first brow pencil from Anastasia. This one says it has a 0.5 millimeter ultra fine tip. It also has the blending brush, which is the spoolie. The spoolie to me is a little bit better because it's thinner, so it grabs the hairs better in my opinion. Some people like the fatter ones, some people like it not to be so dense. I have actually been using this for a little while. If you can't tell, like, packaging is already ripped up, but I kept it because I wanted you guys to see what it is. I picked mine up at Ulta, and when I went, I only found the brunette, which is perfect for me, and the blonde. I didn't see any other shades. I'm gonna assume maybe there's like a dark brown or a black. But I only saw the two in store. So for me and my brows, this has been the best brow pencil I have ever used. I use the newest Benefit one, which I like very much, but I've only used it once. I use the Anastasia one, which was okay for me. It was too waxy for me. My other favorite one was the NYX. The NYX one had topped off every brow pencil I've ever used. But now, this one has topped it off for me, and the reason why is because, if you can't tell, I already have a lot of brow. That's not a problem for me. The only problem I have is that this inner corner here, I have very sparse hairs, so my corner's kind of missing. This one's a little sparse, but not as much. So with this, I fill it in, and it's perfect for me because this is a more dry formula. Because I have more brow hairs, the drier the formula, the better the item is for me. When it's more waxy and I'm trying to get it in my brows, I end up having a heavier hand and my brows end up too dark. I do dye my hair red. I'm not sure if you can see it on this camera, but I do dye my hair red. And when it fades out, it looks really bad when my brows are really dark. So having a drier formula works so well for me. So yes, it is a drier formula. This is in the color brunette. Like I said, it is a skinny pencil. So this is the pencil right here. And then the spoolie is a skinny spoolie, if you can see that too. And I absolutely love this spoolie because it's so thin and it's harder than the usual spoolies. I'm able to blend better for my brows. So I am actually going to demo this pencil so you can see how it looks on my brows. And yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and zoom you in and we'll go ahead and get started. So as of right now, this is what my brows look like. This is them after 3 days of them being waxed. So as you can see, I do have a lot of hairs. I just have to brush them. And I usually like to fill in this corner and this corner. I mean, I do fill in my entire brow just so it looks fuller, but it's not mandatory for my situation. But let's go ahead and get started. So this is... I love how quickly it brushes out my hairs too, and because the spoolie is so small, it grabs every single hair. So I'm gonna start on the bottom of this one. And sometimes I like to make the line thicker at the bottom. So I brush it up, it spreads to the top of my brow, especially for my front brow. Also start right here, get my tail going. Take my spoolie. And I'll brush it upward. And then this I'll just brush to the back. It's mainly right here that I'll end up brushing to the top because I needed to blend upward. Let me see. This right here. I'll make my line on top. Now, a lot of people like to brush their hairs down, do the line, brush their hairs up, do the line. I don't like doing that because I don't like filling in my brows to the max, as mentioned before. So this is just how I keep it, so I can see if there's any sparse areas to fill in. So with this here, because of my front being sparse, I like to brush it down and then brush it up and then just blend out that line. Then I fill it in, but this, when I fill it in the front, I like to have a lighter hand because I don't want my front to be absolutely dark. And then I just blend it out. Make sure there's nothing up here because sometimes I cannot tell. And then there goes one brow. So now I have my little squared front corner compared to this one. See how it's a little bit more fuller? Now, a lot of people like to fill in this back area a lot. I don't, because sometimes, as mentioned before, I do have a heavy hand and I end up messing it all up, and that's not something I really want to do. There we go. So that brow's done. Can you see the difference between the two? So I'm gonna go ahead and do this one. Now this is my more complicated brow. So this one likes to do yoga, go to the gym, eat healthy, and this one just wants to be lazy, eat pizza, not go to school, not go to work. That's why the front is missing. So I'm gonna take a little longer on this brow. So I'll probably speed up this brow since you already saw how I did this one. That's all I do for my brows. I love them this way. I do have some issues with them because I'm very picky. It's just how my brows ended up. They're not identical. They're not going to be twins. Everyone says they're supposed to be sisters. For example, I know this one doesn't come closer to the nose like this one does. This arch is a little farther back than this one is. So sometimes the shapes are a little different, but I don't mind it. My eyebrows used to be so much worse. They were like pencil thin. I used to take razors and just shave it off as thin as possible. So I was blessed. They grew back, thank God. I also have an amazing brow lady. She works at the Ulta in Brandon. She does an amazing job on my brows. She did a whole treatment on me, trying to let them grow back. We do have hairs in my inner corner, but they're so, you could barely see them. It's as if they're transparent. But every time she does my wax and then I wash my face and stuff, that's when I start seeing the hairs. So my brows have come a long way. So having a pencil like this is just amazing for my brows, just because they're a little fuller than some people's. Some people will need the one that has the triangle just because it will end up filling their brows a lot faster. It covers more areas. But for me personally, I like this one of the L'Oreal for my brows. I did do a video on the Ardell one with the triangle tip, and I did really like that one as well. That one I would say would be for people with brows like I do. Just because if you need to fill in sparse areas, it's really fast, it gets it. Any other one, pretty much anyone could use, but with people with thicker brow hairs and just need to fill in sparse areas, this L'Oreal one is amazing. So yes, I do recommend this L'Oreal one, just because it has a drier formula. So because of that, I recommend it mostly to people who have more brows. If you have less brows but you like to have the dryer formula, then yes, I would recommend this for you too. That doesn't mean only people with fuller brows can use this. Anybody can use this, of course. But for anybody who has brows like me and is not sure of what to use, this is a great brow pencil. So that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed this demo and review. Let me know if there's any videos you would like to see, any tutorials, any reviews, anything. Just let me know in the comments below. And yeah, that's about it. So hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.